Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. This is a whole chapter talking about hypothesis testing. And we talked about determining the null and alternative hypothesis. We've talked about finding the test statistic. And we also need to talk about critical values and significance levels. And those are things we've talked about in previous chapters. So a significance level, of 0.10 or 0.05 or 0.01, those relate back to the confidence levels that we had in previous chapters. So remember 90% confidence, that's like 0.1 minus 0.90, that gives us the 0.1. So those are related. Now when we looked at those before, we were talking about two-tailed tests or something, there's area on both sides of the graph. And so we know the critical scores or values for those confidence levels because we've seen those before. And that relates to a two-tailed test. But if you have a left tail, which left tail, notice this, the values here are negative, or a right tail, then those values change because all of the area is under one tail. So for instance, if we had a significance level of 0.1 and we had a two-tailed test, we would divide that 0.1 up into two parts. And so we'd have a little area on the left and a little area on the right. That changes where that value is going to find rather than if we had all the area on the left or all the area on the right. So those are something that you can calculate on your own as you need to, but you can also refer back to this chart. The critical values are different for left and right tail tests because the area is in one tail rather than split into two. So I think maybe looking at this picture that I have here will help you understand that. The critical region or the rejection region is the area corresponding to all values of the test statistics that cause us to reject the null hypothesis. So take a look at the picture because saying it is more confusing than looking at it. So here is a right tail test. That means that our alternative hypothesis is saying go to the right. And we have a critical value here. And this shaded part is the part where we would reject the null. And anything over to the left of that, we would fail to reject the null. In other words, kind of supporting the null, right? If the test statistic is in the shaded region, then we reject the null. So we do that test statistic. Remember, we have the critical value, and then we do the test statistic to say where does it fall. If our test statistic is in the shaded area, then we would reject the null. If our test statistic fell in the unshaded area, then we would fail to reject the null. So we can see it's the same kind of thing if it's a left-tailed test. This shaded area, if our test statistic fell in that area, we would reject the null. Those are like that small bits that we don't like, and then the rest of it is what we do in a way. Think about it that way. And then left tail means that we have a less than value. Notice less than is going to the left and greater than is going to the right. That should make sense to you. And then we also have a two-tailed test where we take that same amount of data, but we split it into two parts. And that's why we end up with different critical values for this, because this is that area divided in two, whereas the other ones are that whole area in the left or the right. And so we would say fail to reject in the center, but reject if our test statistic falls in either of the left or right regions. So that's really the crux of how the critical regions and the test statistics and the significant levels, they're all related because we use one to help us look compared to the other to decide whether to reject or fail to reject the null. And the next video coming up, we'll talk about the p-value. All right, have a fantastic day, and don't forget to subscribe if you'd like to see my other videos as they come out.